The first time we retrieved sediment cores, we didn't understand what was in them. It was just a tube of clay. But the more we learned, the more we realized that a core 1 meter long can contain 10,000 years of information.
Currently, I'm studying how oxygen concentration in coral reefs can vary between different coral structures, so we can help the reefs survive in the future.
Our society needs to change, and I feel that I want to be a small part of that force, moving in the right direction.
The key thing at Stockholm University is that our teaching is very close to our research. So the latest results from research on climate, oceans and the environment is directly taken into the teaching.
As a student with us, you become part of our research environment. When you work on your project, you join a research group and gain access to discussions and the scientific exchange we have. You become a part of the big process of generating new knowledge.
It's clear that the teachers are researchers with a great interest in their subject and that they're actively researching while you're learning.
To solve environmental problems, it's really important to study them on site. And that is what we do at our field stations in the Baltic Sea, but also in tropical oceans. For example, the Galapagos, Southeast Asia and Central America, places where we work on environmental issues.
After you have studied climate, oceans and the environment, you are desired by many different types of employers, both internationally and nationally.
We have finite resources on the Earth, and we must use them sustainably and in the right way. And that means that knowledge about the Earth is extremely important.
It's easy to become frustrated or feel hopelessness about the world that we have destroyed for ourselves. But I still believe that knowledge can help turn that anxiety into action.